So say you're approaching an optional HOV or express lane, and your passenger is saying they would like you to take it. What do you do? And really quickly, I'd like to mention a new app called GetUpside that we've partnered with. I personally have only been using it for a couple of months and have already saved over $30 in gas. And millions of people have already earned millions of dollars. It's really easy. All you have to do is upload your gas receipt and then cash gets added to your account. The cash adds up over time and you can cash it out whenever you want. And if you use our promo code when you sign up, you'll get a $15 per gallon signup bonus. Or you can just visit therideshareguide.com/getupsideapp. Here's a look at Lyft's official policy on tolls. While in an active Lyft ride, toll costs are automatically added to the rider's fare. This means drivers pay tolls up front and then get reimbursed for tolls after the rider pays for the ride. This does not apply to optional tolls, such as those in HOV or express lanes. And if we read further down, fees related to taking optional express or HOV lanes aren't paid for by passengers and will not be reimbursed. Their policy also states, it is against our terms of service for passengers to use cash for portions, for example, toll fees, of a Lyft ride except for tips. So there's their policy. If you come up on an optional toll lane and the passenger asks you to use it, you will not be reimbursed for that toll lane. And if the passenger offers to pay with cash, you're not to accept that either. So what options do you have if a passenger asks you to take an optional toll lane? I've heard that in states like California, they have these optional toll lanes and they're a lot faster than just taking a regular lane. So you could choose that you want the trip to go a lot faster and incur that expense yourself. That is totally your choice though. You also have the option to politely decline. You can tell the passenger that unfortunately you will not be reimbursed for an optional toll lane, so you prefer not to take it. All right, and the last option is something that the passenger might do. They might tell you, oh, I'll tip you really well in the app, or I'll tip you really well in cash. Lyft's policy says that you're not to accept cash for the toll lane, but there's nothing that says that the passenger can't tip, give you a really good cash tip or a really good tip in the app. So yeah, the passenger might give you a really good tip because you took the toll lane, but they're not necessarily paying for that toll. They're just giving you a really good tip because of your good service, because you took the toll lane. That's how you could explain it to Lyft if they were to say, oh, you're not supposed to accept cash for these toll lanes. And what you might want to do to make sure you get paid by the passenger is accept some cash up front. Say, all right, I'm going to take this toll lane, but you're going to need to give me the cash right now so that I can ensure that I'm going to get reimbursed for taking this toll lane. So those are your options. You can choose to take the toll lane yourself and incur the expense yourself. You can politely decline the passenger and say, sorry, I'm not going to be reimbursed. And you can also decide to take a better tip, a better cash tip, cash up front, a better tip in the app. It's totally your choice. Lyft also has an official list of US tolls charged to passengers, and we'll leave this link in the description so you can confirm the approved tolls for your state. Also, in some instances, drivers have to pay a toll when they return to the coverage area, and Lyft calculated those into the fare for passengers as well, and Lyft has an official list for those also. We will leave this link in the description too. And as far as Uber, really quickly, each city might have a different policy. We have heard of drivers submitting fare reviews when using optional toll lanes and getting reimbursed for them. For example, here's a look at the official policy for Orange County. It shows what toll roads drivers will be reimbursed for and also states that they won't be reimbursed for HOV lanes on the 110. But again, you'll want to check the policy in your specific city to see if you can be reimbursed for certain optional toll roads. Again, remember that you won't be automatically paid for those optional toll lanes, but you do have a few different choices. Thanks again for watching. Please like, comment, or subscribe, and drive safe. Thanks.